Hello and welcome to Screen Lifecycle lesson. In this lesson, we will highlight how web applications work under the hood, which is quite different from normal desktop applications in case you come from a different technology. In the process, we will mention two or three OutSystems concepts so that you know how they fit within the lifecycle of a page render in a web application. So how do we get an application page or screen available in our computer so we can interact with it? Well, first the user needs to click on a link or write in a URL in his browser. This will point him to a particular page in our application. When he does that, the browser on his local machine sends a request to a server somewhere else in the world. The server, upon receiving this request, will send a response with the resource that was required of it. And finally, the browser takes that resource in whatever format it is and renders it, presents it to the user on the screen. Steps 1 and 2 in the previous diagram are fairly simple to understand. You just open the browser, you type in the URL, and the browser sends a request to the server where the application is hosted. Step 3 is where it gets interesting. This is where we're going to discuss how the server responds to the request. There are actually two types of possible responses that the server can send, depending on the nature of what was requested. The first one is if you request the static resource, that's when you request something that doesn't need any processing. For example, you ask to download a PDF or a zip or an image. So there is no code involved producing this response. Web applications, however, take care of dynamic requests, whereby you request something that will need some processing to send the response back. So the server will execute some sort of code, some sort of logic, gather any data that it needs, and produce a dynamic response to you, normally an HTML file. When an OutSystem server receives a request for a dynamic content, a screen on your application, the first thing that happens is the variables of this screen are born. You don't need to know all of these details, but just so you have an idea, there's input parameters and there's local variables. The input parameters, you can actually push the values into the input parameters via the URL. These variables obviously only exist during the rendering of the screen, so their scope is limited to the time where the server is rendering this screen for the user. Next, and before the server builds the visual part of the page, it needs obviously to gather the data necessary and do some processing to produce that visual page. This is done in an action called a preparation. This action contains code that runs before the screen is actually built, and you normally find data queries and some logic that prepares, as the name indicates, it prepares the building of the screen. After the preparation completes, the server can then start building the screen, the visual part of the screen. It does so from the top to bottom using widgets. Widgets are just visual controls that are bound to the data that you have fetched in the preparation. Once the building of the screen has completed, the server can then send this response, this dynamic screen, back to the user browser. And finally, when the response arrives to the browser, obviously, the browser renders it to display it to the user. And we have a sample here of a screen from an OutSystems application. So as you can see, the lifecycle of pages is actually quite simple. A request is made to the server, the screen variables are initialized, the preparation runs its code, the screen is built, it's sent back as a response to the browser, and it is displayed to the user. And this is the lifecycle of an application screen in a nutshell. See you guys in the next lesson.